Dinobots are cool. Dinosaurs are cool. Rebellious anti-heroes are cool. Ergo, is there anything cooler than rebellious anti-hero robot dinosaurs? The original Dinobots began life as the Dinosaur Robo from the Japanese Diaclone toy line, which were imported by Hasbro to become part of the second year of the Transformers toy range. The classic team consists of the arrogant leader, Grimlock the Tyrannosaurus, Slag the fiery-tempered Triceratops, Sludge the dim-witted Brontosaurus, Snarl the aloof Stegosaurus, and Swoop the friendly Pteranodon. Together, they're a team of loose cannons, terrifying powerhouses the Decepticons can rarely stand against, but ones who only follow Optimus Prime's orders begrudgingly, if at all. The original Marvel Comics miniseries presented the Dinobots as part of the crew of the Autobots spaceship when it crashed on Earth 4 million years ago. When the Decepticon Shockwave arrived on the planet soon after, the ship's computer reactivated the five to battle him, giving them dinosaur alternate modes based on the beasts that lived in the Savage Land, a prehistoric tropical jungle hidden in the Antarctic from Marvel's X-Men comic books. Shockwave trapped the Dinobots in a tar pit where they remained until they were found and freed by Ratchet in the present day. The American comic didn't do much with the team for a few years after their introduction, but they became instant favourites of British writer Simon Furman, who penned multiple stories for the UK version of the comic that gave the team starring roles as they struck out on their own adventures. The cartoon, on the other hand, featured a very different origin story. In it, the Dinobots were built on Earth by Wheeljack and Ratchet, who were inspired by the discovery of a cave of fossilized dinosaur bones in the Autobots' volcano headquarters. Just like real dinosaurs, the cartoon Dinobots were small of brain, which led them to speak in a primitive, caveman-like way, and resulted in them causing trouble for the Autobots almost as much as they did for the Decepticons, even turning on their creators more than once. They enjoyed regular, prominent showcase appearances all throughout the series, but their supporting turn in the Transformers the movie marked the beginning of a decline, as it and the subsequent third season exploited their lack of intelligence to downgrade them from fearsome warriors to the series' comic relief. It was as the cartoon was reaching its end that the Dinobots returned to the spotlight in the comic when Grimlock was appointed Autobot leader following the death of Optimus Prime. His reign was a tyrannical one that alienated many of the Autobots serving under him, but he remained in charge for nearly 2 years until he and the rest of the Dinobots were offlined by the cosmically empowered Starscream. But by this point, their popularity among audiences had become obvious to Hasbro. In 1989, a new classic pretender action figure of Grimlock was released, leading to his resurrection in the comic's pages. And the year after, he and Snarl were also given new figures as part of the Action Master range of toys, precipitating the return of the entire team to the comic for its final few issues. And their popularity persisted when the series was rebooted as Transformers Generation 2, with Grimlock, Slag, and Snarl's original toys made available again, and the whole team continuing to appear in the new comic book. Now, as we've talked about in past episodes, when characters are depicted in notably different ways between the Marvel comic and the Generation 1 cartoon, it usually means that writers of new media get to pick and choose and blend different elements from both together when creating new versions of them. But with the Dinobots, there's virtually no contest. Almost every new take on their origin story goes the Marvel route, depicting them as natives of Cybertron. And one of the first to do so was Dreamwave Productions, who revealed through their comics that on Cybertron, the team were known as the Dinobots with a Y, and were part of a larger Lightning Strike Coalition splinter faction led by Grimlock. In fact, the only major exception to the widespread use of the Marvel-style origin was in Transformers Animated, in which the more cartoon-inspired Dinobots were originally theme park animatronics, modified by Megatron to function as attack drones, which were inadvertently brought to life by the power of the Allspark. This smaller version of the team consists of Grimlock, who's the only one capable of speech, Swoop, and a Triceratops who was going to be Slag, but had to have his name changed to Snarl when Hasbro discovered that Slag is a rude word in the United Kingdom. The animated Dinobots lived out of the way on an island in Lake Erie, but often fell under the sway of villains like Meltdown and Black Arachnia, leading to clashes with the Autobots. The Aligned Continuities version of the Dinobots is functionally identical to the Generation 1 team. They debuted in the Fall of Cybertron video game in 2012, which borrowed from Dreamwave and named the team the Lightning Strike Coalition Force prior to their gaining their dinosaur alternate modes. And they got those modes after being captured and experimented on by Shockwave, who sought to turn them into berserker warriors by tampering with their genetics using information gleaned from studying Earth's dinosaurs via Space Bridge. Sludge was mostly absent from the game, but returned to the team in tie-in comic books, which continued the Dinobots' story, detailing how they stayed on Cybertron after it became mostly abandoned, seeking revenge on Shockwave and protecting the few Autobots who remained on the planet. For this version of the team, Slag was renamed Slug, which became the character's new name in all media going forward. And that included IDW Publishing's comic books, which took an additional inspiration from the Aligned version of the story by depicting the Dinobots, with a Y, as the victims of a different kind of experimental science. IDW added a sixth member to the team, Scar, a medic who unintentionally cursed his teammates with uncontrollable, monstrous alternate modes based on ancient Cybertronian reptiles when testing out a new means of alt-mode adaptation. The mutated Dinobots killed Scar in their frenzy and were forced to go on the run, but were eventually found and cured of their condition by the Autobots. They went on to gain their more familiar earthly dinosaur forms in a story that homaged their Marvel origins, when they battled Shockwave on prehistoric Earth, only to wind up buried on the planet for millennia. And things haven't gone that well for the team since awakening in the modern day. Grimlock has wound up mentally impaired and is currently in the care of a group of repentant Decepticons known as the Scavengers, while the other Dinobots are outlaws living in the wilderness of Cybertron. Now, so far, we've just talked about versions of the Dinobots directly based on the classic characters. But the fact is, as popular as they were and are, the simple innate appeal of something as cool as robot dinosaurs has meant that, over time, the idea of the Dinobots has proven much bigger than the original five bots themselves. In addition to their continuing appearances, the term Dinobot has come to be widely used to refer to a huge array of Transformers with dinosaur alternate modes, not just the original five. This was most famously evinced as early as 1996 during Beast Wars, in which Dinobot was the name of an honorable Predacon warrior, a Velociraptor who was cast out by his era's version of Megatron and joined forces with the heroic Maximals. Beast Wars Dinobot enjoyed a perpetually antagonistic relationship with his new teammates, especially the smart-mouthed Rattrap, and grappled with heavy issues like identity and free will, ultimately proving his honor by sacrificing his life to stop Megatron from altering history and wiping out mankind. An evil clone was engineered by Megatron to take Dinobot's place, but the original's goodness shone through, and the clone turned on his maker, leading to his ultimate defeat in the Beast Wars. Dinobot was one of the most popular characters of the Beast Era, and was the first fan-chosen entry into the Transformers Hall of Fame in 2010. And in fiction, his legacy lived on in the Beast Machines Dinobots, another group of dinosaur beast warriors who carried his DNA. Following the Beast Era, the first decade of the 21st century brought many more new Dinobots, some of them brand new characters unrelated to the originals like the Dinobots of the Beast Era had been, and others serving as partial homages to the classic team, reusing some of their names, if not their forms. But the original team's influence would always reassert itself. The Transformers Energon toy line featured its own incarnations of Grimlock and Swoop, who were able to combine together to form Mega Dinobot. And we mentioned IDW Scar earlier, but he wasn't the first time a sixth member was added to the Generation 1 Dinobot team. The first was Paddles the Plesiosaurus, a one-shot character featured in a short story in 2004's Transformers Legends prose collection. Later, in 2010, the Power Core Combiners toy line introduced Grimstone, a new character who shared the iconic color scheme of the originals, and who, in Japan, was reimagined as a new rookie recruit for the G1 team. The world of the live-action movies split the difference with 2014's Age of Extinction by featuring all five members of the classic team, albeit with Sludge and Swoop renamed Slog and Strafe, respectively, along with two new members, Scorn the Spinosaurus and Slash the Velociraptor. Only Grimlock, Slug, Scorn and Strafe actually appeared in the film, in which they were ancient warriors captured by the bounty hunter Lockdown. Optimus Prime freed them to help defend Hong Kong, but the arrogant Grimlock had to have a little sense knocked into him before he agreed to follow Prime's orders. They were still around in the last night, having somehow spawned mini Dinobots in their own image. The Age of Extinction Dinobots were heavily featured in the promotional material for the film, despite the fact they only appeared in the movie's final act, and several other series rode that wave of Dinomania. The cast of Rescue Bots all became Dinobots when they took on new dinosaur alternate modes, including Optimus Prime himself. The 2015 Robots in Disguise cartoon featured Dinobots as a unique subspecies of Transformer, including a new incarnation of Grimlock. A whole wave of new dinosaur-themed combiner characters was released as part of the Creo building block toy range. And the IDW Dinobots were joined by a new sixth member, the two-headed alien dinosaur Strafe, the first female Dinobot, who took her name from the Age of Extinction character, who also had two heads. And lastly, that brings us to the upcoming Power of the Primes toyline, in which it was recently announced all five classic Dinobots will be appearing in their original Generation 1 forms for the first time since the original series, along with a female G1 version of Slash. But that's not all. The toys will be able to combine into a super robot named Volcanicus, a name derived from one of the Creo Dinobot combiners, Volcanicon. But this isn't the first time the Dinobots have combined. That dubious honor belongs to a fan-made mini-comic titled The Beast Within, which was included with the UK DVD release of the Generation 1 cartoon in 2004. Known only as The Beast, this misshapen Dinobot combiner was a mindless monstrosity who was a threat to Autobot and Decepticon alike. It remains to be seen if Volcanicus will be as dangerous, but we can be sure he'll munch metal, bash brains, and generally act prehistoric. And those are the basics on the Dinobots. Which incarnation do you like most? Who's your favorite team member? Is there a dinosaur you'd like to see become a Dinobot? As always, have your say in the comments, like and subscribe, and consider supporting the basics on Patreon.